In this video, we will see how to use regressors in Monolix. A regressor, or a regression variable, is a variable which is defined in the dataset and used in the model. Let's first have a look at an example of a structural model without regressor. In this simple PKPD model, there are 5 input variables, Ka, V, K, E0, and IC50. There are constant parameters that will be estimated by Monolix for each individual and can be seen in the individual model. CC and E, which represent the PK and the effect, are variables defined in the model as functions of time. They will be computed based on the dosing information from the dataset and the values of the input. The predicted effect will be matched to the PD observations in the dataset. Let's now consider a case where Ka, V, and K are already known for each individual, for example, based on a previous PK analysis, and are included in the dataset as additional columns along with the PD observations in the column Y2. It is possible to read their values from the dataset instead of estimating them by tagging each column as a regressor. In the structural model, Ka, V, and K are defined as regressors by simply adding these 3 lines after the input definition. Note that the mapping with the regressor columns in the dataset is done by order of definition, not by name. Then only E0 and IC50 will be estimated by Monolix and can be seen in the individual model. This is a simple way to perform a sequential estimation of a joint PK/PD model. In this example, the regressors are constant over time. However, a regressor can also vary in time. To illustrate this case, let's now see the example where the PK prediction has been added to the dataset as a column YPK. It is then possible to use it directly as a regressor to compute the effect E. The column YPK is tagged as a regressor, and CC is defined as a regressor input in the structural model. The value of CC with respect to time will be taken from the YPK column. Note again that the name of the regressor does not have to be the same as the name of the column. In this slide, we can see in detail the regressor value in blue and the result for the prediction in purple for the first times of the first individual. At each time point, the regressor interpolation is performed by using the last given value. So CC is piecewise constant, and since the effect model is direct, the predicted effect is therefore piecewise constant as well. There can be missing values in the regressor column, indicated with a dot, for example here. But for the first record of each subject, the regressor value cannot be missing. For time points not defined in the dataset, interpolations are done using last observation carried forward. So between the times 0 and 6, the regressor value is the one defined on time 0. Then at time 6, the regressor value becomes 11.04. At time 12, the regressor value is missing, so it stays the same. Regressors are also frequently used as initial value for a variable defined with an ODE or a function. On this example, a tumor growth model depends on the initial tumor volume TS0 at time 0. This value is taken from the dataset with a regressor. In that case, only the values from the regressor column corresponding to time 0 are used. This page of the online documentation explains how regressors can also be used to define complex parameter covariate relationships that cannot be defined in the interface, or to handle time-varying covariates. You can see a detailed example of time-varying covariate definition in the feature of the week video number 15. Finally, you will find more details on our online documentation, including how the interpolation is handled for more complex cases, for example, when additional doses are added with a column steady state or a column additional doses.